亲爱的同学们，你们好，我是你们的汉语老师谷老师。今天我们学习 HSK 二第三课，左边那个红色的是我的。Points of today: the first one, the phrase. Can you make sentence with the? Please think about it. The first time we learned the is to indicate the position. For example, 这是我的爸爸。This is my father. 我的、他的、你的、我们的、你们的、他们的。The to indicate the position. Then we learned the structure of a sentence like 是的 in the end. This is to emphasize the time, the place, and the manner. For example, 我们是2019年认识的。We know each other in 2019. Okay, then today we will learn the other function of the. Number two is 一下。一下 is very easy to indicate a short moment for a short time. For example, I always say have a break, 休息一下，休息一下。So we can use a verb plus 一下。For example, I say, "Wow, this book is very good." 这本书太好了。你看一下，你看一下，Have a look，你看一下。哇，这个音乐太好听了，音乐 music is so good，太好听了。你听一下，你听一下。你听一下，哎，For example，哇，中国菜太好吃了，so delicious。你吃一下，你吃一下，means have a try，right？OK，this 一下 means a short time。Number three is 真，真 means really，so we use 真。We use 真 plus adjective. 真 means really. For example, I say, 你的汉语真好 means your Chinese is really good. 中国菜真好吃，right? 真漂亮，你真忙，You are really busy。你真忙，OK？真 plus adjective。OK，now let's learn the lesson now。First, let's learn the new words。请跟我读生词。手表，手表。手 means hand. Like we say, there's cell phone, 手机, right? 手机. But the watch is on the hand. We say 手表, 手表. Can you make one sentence with 手表? 我有一个手表. I have a new watch. 我有一个新的手表，right? Okay, now 手表 now this one 报纸，okay? 报纸 newspaper 报纸 We can say 看报纸 or 读报纸 So how to say he is reading the newspaper? 他在看报纸，哦，他在读报纸。How to say today's newspaper? 今天的报纸。How to say tomorrow's newspaper? 明天的报纸。Okay, next one, 牛奶，牛奶。New means milk and nai. Oh, sorry. New means cow and nai means milk. 牛奶，okay? 牛奶，牛奶。So we can say 喝牛奶，喝牛奶。Can you make a sentence with 牛奶？For example，他在喝牛奶。我喜欢喝牛奶。我去超市买牛奶。Okay, many sentences you can make. 房间，房间，房间 means room. 房间 means room. So in the room, we can say 房间里。房间里，Can you make a sentence with 房间？这是我的房间。这个房间真大，really big。这个房间太漂亮了，so beautiful。There's a table in the room。房间里有一个桌子。OK，Can you make some other sentence? The next one，丈夫 means husband。Husband，Can you make a sentence with 丈夫？这是我丈夫。我丈夫是医生。OK，丈夫。哦，谁是你丈夫？Who is your husband？来，红色，红色，红 means red is adjective，色 means color，红色 means the red color。OK，红色，and 红，OK，红 ，We can say 红衣服，红衣服。哦，红色的衣服。Now and so this one thousand 千，一千，两千，三千。你的手表多少钱？一千，两千，还是三千？好，左边，left side。At the left side，在左边。On the left side，在左边。We can say，for example，我的妈妈在左边。My mom is on the left，right？我的妈妈在左边。OK，now this one is 旁边。OK，this always 边边 means side，来、right? 左边，旁边，旁边 means beside，哦 at the side。OK，旁边，我的妈妈在旁边，我的妈妈在旁边。Now 送 means to deliver，送。Some people they deliver the milk. So in China, there are some people who deliver the milk for the family every day. So they are 送牛奶. They are 送牛奶. And maybe some people will deliver the letter, right? Deliver the newspaper. 送报纸. 送牛奶。Okay, now this one 一下 we already learned, right? Used after a verb means to do something in for a very short time. Like this one 颜色 color, okay? 颜色. 你的衣服. Please listen to my question, okay? 吴老师的衣服是什么颜色的？吴老师的衣服是什么颜色的？吴老师的衣服是黄色，yellow。OK，是黄色的。This one 粉 pink 粉色。It's not pink color. OK，pink。OK，this is the new words part. Let's read it again. 手表，报纸，牛奶，房间，丈夫，红色，红，天，左边，旁边，送，一下。颜色，粉色。The first language point is about this. This is the most important language point in this lesson. The first one is to indicate the position. Actually, we already learned. And in this lesson, for example, I say, 这是我的手机，这是他的手机。This is my cell phone, and this is his cell phone. Then we can say, this is mine, this is his, right? Because we are in this conversation context, we are talking about this cell phone. Then we can say, this is mine. This is his. Right? This is mine. We will say, 这是我的，这是他的。Okay? So, we will say somebody 的。Now please make a sentence like this. Something 是 somebody 的。Something, we can use this structure. 这。Plus measure word plus noun. Like we say, this cell phone, 这个手机。This book, 这本书。Okay, now please try to make sentence. For example, how to say, this Chinese book is 吴老师's. Means this book belongs to 吴老师, right? This Chinese book is 吴老师's. Then we will say, 这本汉语书是吴老师的。Can you make a similar sentence? Please try. Okay, now, please look at here. Please read this question. 这块手表是你的吗？这块手表是我的，手表，watch。The major word we can use 块，yeah, we can use 块。Quite is a major word. Actually, for 手表 we can also use the major word 个 and we can also use 快. We know 快 is for money, right? But 快 can be also as a major word for the thing, like a piece. You know, a piece of cake, we can say 快. Right? A piece of beef, we can also say 块. Okay? So, But please remember, for the watch, we can use quite and the good both, correct? OK，这块手表是你的吗？这块手表是我的。OK，now let's do the dialogue, please, like this. For example, we have the noun like 房间、汉语书，and the 小猫、小狗、杯子。So all of these, the major word for 汉语书 is 本。Right, for 汉语书 is 本，and the other word we can all use 个，right? We can all use 个。So to ask the question, is this room yours? Is this Chinese book yours? Is this cat yours? Like this, okay? How to ask this answer? 这个房间是你的吗？这个房间是我的。这本汉语书是你的吗？这本汉语书不是我的。OK, please try. OK, ask and answer, affirmative and negative answer. OK, now let's go on. The structure 是的 actually we already learned that, right? For example, about this 手表 the watch. Now we can ask the question use this. This structure 是的，and 是 is optional here, right? We can say 你的手表在哪儿买的？Means where? It's where that you bought your watch, right? 你的手表在哪儿买的？你的手表多少钱买的？How much that you bought this watch? 你的手表什么时候买的？This the Right, this is a 是的 phrase, right? Okay, actually, we already learned this structure before, right? Now we just make a review. Now let's answer these three questions, okay? 你的手表是在哪儿买的？我的手表是在中国买的。你的手表是多少钱买的？我的手表是。1000块买的，你的手表是什么时候买的？我的手表是今年 this year 买的。OK，let's try. OK，please do this dialogue. Ask and answer yourself. OK，please try this structure. OK，now let's go. The first one is to indicate. The last one is to indicate the modifier. For example, we say. Tomorrow's newspaper. Tomorrow's newspaper. 明天的报纸。Yesterday's newspaper. 昨天的报纸。Okay, this is easy to understand. And then, the people who deliver the milk. How to say this one? Deliver the milk, we say, 送。牛，奶，and the people that is 人，the people who deliver the milk 送牛奶的人，OK，送牛奶的人，the students in Beijing University，can you try？How to say Beijing University? 北京大学。The students 学生，and we put the between this modifier and this head word here. So we will say 北京大学的学生。Okay, the last one, please have a try. How to say the shop that is in the school? We can say 学校的商店，哦，学校里的商店，OK？Can you understand？Let's read this phrase。明天的报纸，昨天的报纸，送牛奶的人，北京大学的学生，学校里的商店，OK？Now。 So make a summary here about this the phrase. This one is to indicate the position, somebody 的。这是我的，这是你的，这是他的，这是吴老师的。This is mine. This is yours. This is his. This is 吴老师's. Okay, now somebody 的。And the second one is this structure 是的。什么时候买的？When did you buy？哪买的？Where did you buy？怎么买的？How did you buy the manner？OK，、okay? Now this structure to indicate the modifier. We will use this modifier plus the plus noun. OK，Now, for example, this is the pictures from the previous semester. And they belong to different class. If this class is class 1, this class is class 2. Class 1, we say 一般. Class 2, that is 二班. Okay, now, how to say they are the students from Class one，他们是一般的学生。In the same way, how to say this one？他们是二班的学生。Then we can just say this sentence in short。他们是二班的，他们是三班的。Sorry, that is class two and class three, right? Okay. Now，他们是二班的，他们是三班的。OK，Now please look at this example sentence. Read it and try to understand. 红的杯子是我的，粉的杯子是他的。The red cup is mine. The pink cup is his. 我有很多学生。中国的、巴基斯坦的、孟加拉国的、哥伦比亚的、埃及的。I have many students from China, from Pakistan, from Bangladesh, right? 孟加拉国的，Bangladesh, sorry. Okay, now 中国的、巴基斯坦的。孟加拉国的，that means 中国的学生，巴基斯坦的学生，孟加拉国的学生，like this. Okay? Next one. 学校里，in the school, 有很多花，花 means flowers. Remember the dog, 花花，right? 学校里有很多花。There are many flowers in the school. 红的，粉的。Red one, the pink one, the big one, the small one. Means red flower, pink flower, big flower, small flower. We can just remove the head word and say 红的，粉的，大的，小的。Right? Just like in English, we say the red one, the pink one. We don't need to say like the red flowers, the pink flowers, the big flowers, the small flowers, right? We just say a red one, pink one, and the big one, the small one, right? 红的、粉的、大的、小的。Okay, now the last sentence. 我妹妹是送牛奶的。送牛奶的，我哥哥是送报纸的。What's the meaning? Means my younger sister is the person who deliver the milk. This is to indicate the job, okay? And my brother is the person who deliver the newspaper. 送牛奶的，送报纸的。Okay, now. Let's read this text together. 在房间 in the room。这块手表是你的吗？不是我的，是我爸爸的。多少钱买的？买的。The in the end to emphasize the time, the place, the manner。多少钱买的？How much you call it? You bought it? 3000多块。三千多块 means more than 3000, right? 三千多块，OK? 三千多块。Now, let's read this text again. This one 手表。This one 多少钱买的？This one 三千 3000. Let's read it without 拼音。这块手表是你的吗？不是我的，是我爸爸的。多少钱买的？三千多块。Text two，在家里，at home，or we can just say 在家，OK？这是今天早上的报纸吗？今天早上，this morning means the paper from this morning。不是，是昨天的。No，it's yesterday's newspaper，right？昨天的。Then 报纸 here is removed means it's yesterday's newspaper. We can just say it's yesterday's, right? 昨天的。你听，listen，你听，是不是？Is that 送报纸的来了？Is that the man who deliver the newspaper is coming？是不是送报纸的来了？我看一下，means let me see。我看一下，let me have a look。不是，是送牛奶的，送牛奶的。OK，now let's read this once again。报纸，newspaper。送报纸的，and 送牛奶的。这是今天早上的报纸吗？不是，是昨天的。你听，是不是送报纸的来了？我看一下，不是，是送牛奶的。OK，language points to 一下，this is very easy. We use verb plus 一下。To indicate a short action, like we can say, 看一下，听一下，说一下，吃一下，喝一下，等一下。We use 等一下 very often. 等一下 means wait a minute. Okay, I always say 等一下，等一下，wait a minute. 等一下，等一下，OK, 等一下，wait a minute. Okay, this is for 一下。Now. Language point three is 真 plus adjective means really means indeed. Now please read this adjective words together. 好吃 delicious, 好看 good looking, 好喝 means good for drinking, 漂亮 beautiful, happy 高兴 cold 冷 hot 热 big 大 small 小。Okay, can you make a sentence, for example, with these adjectives? For example, with 好吃 we can say 中国菜真好吃。With 好看，这个电影 this movie 真好看，right? 好喝，咖啡真好喝，漂亮，她真漂亮。Okay, can you make more sentence with the other adjective words? Please have a try. 真 plus adjective. Okay. Now, this one 旁边 beside. Okay. To indicate the locality, right? For example, if I say, we will say something 在 something 的旁边 means, something is beside. Something. Okay, so for example, we will say like 椅子在桌子旁边。哦，桌子在椅子旁边。Okay, please answer my question. 现在谁在你旁边？在你旁边，谁在你旁边？Who is beside you? For example, my daughter is beside me. 现在我女儿在我旁边。My wife is beside me. 现在我太太在我旁边。My mom is beside me. 现在我妈妈在我旁边，OK，在我旁边，嗯哼 ，OK，this is 旁边，OK，旁边，OK，旁边 also means at the side. For example, please read this sentence. 那个房间是我的房间。Can you understand this sentence? Means that room is my room. 那个房间是我的房间。Then I have a modifier. 那个小的房间是我的房间。That small room is my room. Then I can put the second modifier here. This is to indicate the locality, right? 旁边那个小的房间是我的房间。Okay, that means if in one sentence there are two modifier, if there's one modifier is to indicate the locality, then we will put the locality modifier at first, then the second modifier, maybe it's to just to make a description, right? Description. The big room, the small room, the pink room, the black room, the blue room, like this. This is a kind of description. But if there's another modifier that's to indicate the locality, you have to put the locality first. Okay? So this sentence we should say, 旁边那个小的房间是我的房间。Okay? OK，旁边那个小的房间是我的房间。OK，now please look at here. This is 小的房间。OK，this is 小的房间。And this is 大的房间，大。Then 旁边，this is beside，right？Beside。Then we will say 旁边那个小的房间是我的房间。OK，now。This is about the. Now let's make some practice here. For example, 左边 left side. The red book on the left is mine. Now there are two modifier. One is red book, and the locality modifier on the left. Then we will say the locality modifier first. Okay, right? How to say this? One, we will say, this is the first one, this is the second one, right? 左边，那个，红色的书。左边那个红色的书是我的。OK，or you can also say 那本。OK，左边那本红色的书是我的。If you just say 左边红色的书是我的，it's also okay. OK，it's also okay. Now this one, the small room at the side is my son's. At the side 旁边，the small room 小的。OK，旁边那个小的房间是我儿子的。旁边，右边，the pink cup on the right is his。On the right，右边，粉色的 杯子，右边那个粉色的杯子是他的。OK，let's read this sentence。左边那本红色的书是我的，旁边那个小的房间是我的，是儿子的。右边那个粉色的杯子是他的。OK，now take three。这是谁的房间？Whose room is this？这是我和我丈夫的。旁边那个小的房间是我女儿的。你女儿的房间真漂亮。是啊，粉色是我女儿最喜欢的颜色。这是谁的房间？Whose room is it？这是我和我丈夫的。This is my husband and me's room。旁边那个小的房间是我女儿的，means let small room beside is my daughter's。你女儿的房间真漂亮，Your daughter's room is indeed beautiful。都是粉色的，all pink。Yes，是啊，粉色 pink 是我女儿最喜欢的颜色，最喜欢的颜色。Favorite color，最喜欢的颜色，粉色是我最喜欢的颜色。OK，粉色是我最喜欢的颜色。OK，now 粉色是我最喜欢的颜色。Now what is your favorite color？你最喜欢的颜色是什么？Now we know like 红色，哎。This is red and blue，蓝色，and yellow，黄色，sorry。And green，绿色。One more purple. Oh, sorry. Purple is 紫色。Okay, now and white 白色。Okay, now what's the so. And how to say what is your favorite color？你最喜欢的颜色是什么？我最喜欢的颜色是绿色。你呢？Please make a sentence to tell me which color is your favorite color. OK, once again，绿色。是我最喜欢的颜色。Or you can say 我最喜欢的颜色是绿色。OK, now let's go on. Now let's read this text without 拼音。丈夫，旁边，真，粉色，颜色。这是谁的房间？这是我和我丈夫的。旁边那个小的房间是我女儿的。你女儿的房间真漂亮，都是粉色的。是啊，粉色是我女儿最喜欢的颜色。OK, the last one，在办公室，in the office。In the office，你看见我的杯子了吗？Means did you see my cup？这里有几个杯子？There are several。Several 杯子 here, several 几个，哪个是你的？Which one is yours？哪个是你的？Which one is yours？左边那个红色的是我的。Means 左边，first the locality, then the description modifier。左边那个红色的是我的。 给你，给你 means give you. Here you are. Remember, this 给 we lend. Call somebody. 给 somebody 打电话 means to, right? This is a preposition, and 给 is also a verb equal to give. Give somebody. 给你，here you are. 给你，OK，给你，给你，OK，Now let's read。你看见我的杯子了吗？这里 means here，OK，we can say 这里，like 这儿，OK，这儿。这里有几个杯子，哪个是你的？Which one is yours？左边那个红色的是我的，给你，给你，here you are。Okay, now, that's our recorded lesson. Okay, see you soon. 再见。